Okay, I'm sitting here with Naomi Lawrence in New York City, who has just come over from London, England, and I have just learned that Naomi is a wonderfully creative crocheter. Naomi, do you just want to tell me a little bit about what you do and how you got to do it?
Okay, I do a version of street art called yarn bombing and street graffiti. Well, knit graffiti, really. So it's about colouring up the neighbourhoods with yarn. But I've done various things, like covering lampposts with rectangular pieces, and now I'm kind of branching into crochet flowers and just hanging them on fences in the neighbourhood. It's a way of being generous to the neighbourhood.
Do you want to tell me about what you did for Valentine's Day?
For Valentine's Day, I wanted to do I was actually in Liverpool at the time, we were waiting for immigration for our visas, and I wanted to do a kind of Beatles-themed love yarn bomb. So I did three tree covers to go on a roundabout that said love, 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 and all in sort of hot pinks, reds, dusky pinks, and that was mainly crocheting, not knitting that time.
Wonderful. And also you showed me a beautiful photo of a bike with crochet all over it. What was that all about?
Yeah, that was for a charity called You Can Too, which is a charity in Cambridge in the UK. And they actually approached me because they'd seen some of the yarn bombing that I'd done, and they asked me if I would consider doing a piece that they could use as an advertising tool for the charity. They supply bikes for the disabled, and they were going to have a bike festival to promote and encourage people to be involved. So what we came up with was a bike, a dead bike, so a bike that was no longer in use. I had it stripped by a local bike guy, and so took all the chains off, took everything off it that we could possibly, that could damage the wall, and we basically made it so that the wheels would stop, the pedals wouldn't go around, and then I crocheted and knitted a cover for it, and it was in the brightest colours possible, which are actually the charity's colours. And then we placed the bike in 10 different locations around Cambridge over 10 weeks, with advertising on as well for the bike charity and for the event. And it just to draw attention, and I don't know how many people came to the event because of the bike, but it really got people talking all over Cambridge.
Wonderful. What is the favourite project? What is your favourite project that you've worked on?
I actually really enjoyed the iris, because that's something very different for me, and that's me not just being a yarn bomber, somebody who just puts crazy knitting all over trees and lampposts, but as an artist, for me, I wanted to do something that tied my floristry background and the sculpture that I've done with flowers and wood before. I wanted to tie that into my new hobby, my new art, which is crochet. But it's so different to what I've done, that I've kind of really put myself out there and been quite vulnerable to criticism as well, but I do love that. But one of the other things that stood out for me is the first thing I ever did, which was a lamppost at the end of the road, and people wanted more, so then I got more people involved and we could do larger scale installations around the city.
Wonderful. And at the moment you're working on a day lily.
Yeah, I've almost finished the day lily. It's again like the iris, so I am sticking my neck out a bit. I don't know what the response will be. But, and also it's a more standard flower. It's got six petals and stamens, so hopefully it'll be recognisable. A lot of people thought the iris was a butterfly, so I think people will know what it is, but it may get ripped off like the iris has been. But it made it 3 weeks, and it just takes one person to just give it a yank and it comes off.
Where is this one going to go?
I think it's going to go on Park Avenue on around about 112th. Which is just up the road from where we are. There's a particular dark spot, but lots of people pass it. And behind the fence is a black sheet of plastic, and I think it'll look quite good there, and also it'll brighten up one of the most dingy neighbourhoods. And that's a decision I made recently, is to put my work in the dingiest areas and maybe not the most, the coolest area where, you know, the really sort of other artistic people will pass. I wanted it to be somewhere that actually needed to be brightened up and wasn't really looked after. Favourite things to do, the things I get the most out of is when I do a project for a charity and when they can use the piece of work I've done to advertise and promote the charity. So the bike is still being used outdoors for festivals and fairs all around Cambridge. So,
wow, that's wonderful.
It's fantastic. It's an advertising tool.
Wonderful. Well, it's beautiful. I am just blown away by how beautiful your art is. And I had never before heard about yarn bombing. So I am going to learn more about it. I think it's wonderful creative art. So
I'm
thank
sure
you.
I'm sure there's some in Seattle. You've got to find it.
Yes, yeah. Definitely. Thank you. Yeah.